Hi guys and welcome to Namami Life. This is our second episode of Fit as Fiddle with me, Harman Sidhu. Can we just have a thumbs up for if my audio and video is clear? I hope I'm audible and visible. Can I please have a thumbs up for that? Great. So today we are going to be talking a little more about postpartum workouts. When is it a good idea to start working out? Which are the exercises that you can safely do postpartum, especially the ones after C-section, because a C-section is a major abdominal surgery. So we're going to be talking about these exercises and not just talking. I'm going to be showing you some of the exercises that are very, very safe that you can literally start doing a few days after your surgery and even if you've had a normal vaginal birth. So these are the exercises. That are already doing it during their pregnancy. So these are the exercises that I'm going to be showing you today, and we are also going to be talking about some of the exercises that you should completely avoid doing postpartum, and when is it a good idea to start doing strength training, when is it a good idea to start your high intensity interval training. And we are also going to be talking about some of the signs that probably you are pushing your body way too harder and when is it a good time to kind of stop. So if you have any questions regarding anything, please leave them down below, and as and when we keep going ahead, I will answer them side by side. So I'm going to be first talking about the exercises that you can start postpartum and when is it a good idea to start. So even if you have been, like we discussed in a previous episode, even if you've been exercising all through your pregnancy and even before it, that will kind of decide how much and how faster you will be able to get back to your exercises. But even then, it is always an absolutely necessary that you take a go ahead from your practitioner, your doctor, before you start any kind of exercises, because there are so many things that probably, you know, you aren't even aware, and your doctor would kind of suggest that you take things slow and how you need to go about your exercise. So you really need to discuss with your doctor when you wish to start exercising, so that, you know, you have a green signal to go. Once you have got a go ahead from your doctor, the first and most important thing, like I discussed in the previous episode also, is that you start walking. It is very important that you take up walking and start getting as mobile as possible. I'm sure if, all the new moms today know that for a fact, that after you've had your C-section, you are made to walk as soon as like maybe 24 hours, and you ask to start walking up and getting up and doing things yourself. So it's very important that you start getting mobile. So that's the idea. So after you have started, resumed your walking, it's important that you start stretching yourself, because after what your body has gone through in the 9 months of pregnancy, your body starts to get stiff postpartum, and you know, you really want to stretch it out, get your muscles all warmed up before you get to any workouts. So once you've been given a go-ahead from your doctor, it's very important that you begin with stretching and strengthening of your muscle and your core, especially your core. Strengthening that core postpartum is very, very important. We are going to be talking about spot reduction, because it's something that, you know, every woman would talk about, because the only part that you kind of focus on and is on your mind constantly is your bulging belly. So we would be talking about that later, but right now I want to really focus on strengthening the core, because it's very, very important, you know, that you heal the core and strengthen it instead of just trying to lose weight from your abdomen. That is like the last thing. We would be talking about that later, but currently I'm going to be showing you some of the exercises that are safe to strengthen your core and your muscle, and you know, keep you kind of get your body prepared for exercise. So once you have been okay with walking and you've kind of built a little bit of stamina, which is very good to build with walking, even though it is such a simple thing to do, but you can easily build strength and stamina with just walking, which is what you really need to get through your workouts, right? So once you're done with that, you can start with simple, very, very basic exercises of strengthening your body at home. So we are first going to be, I'm going to be showing you some of the exercises that you can do that I did right in the hospital itself, which are very safe. But again, I'd like to tell you that you can try them right now, but I would still say if you are just a new mom, I'd suggest you please take advice from your doctor, bookmark this, and then you can try them. They are very, very basic and very simple, but I know for a fact that when you are on the hospital bed, the last thing that comes to your mind is that you want to start exercising. And when you do think of it, that you know you should exercise, you probably just imagine yourself going to a gym or working out, you know, doing those hardcore exercises and workouts, and you think that that's all that you need, which is not true. Even simple, very, very basic exercises are, you know, very, very effective, and they must be performed in order to work and build yourself up in your workouts. So we are first going to be doing some of the exercises, and then we're going to come back and talk. Then we're going to come back and talk about other things that I told you that we would discuss today. Later, I mean, this is something that you can obviously discuss with your doctor, but this is something that you really should do to avoid any kind of clotting, you know, and kind of getting the blood moving all around your body. Because I know for a fact that after you had a C-section, you are on the bed and it's so difficult to move. So this is something that can really help you get started and get moving actually. So we are going to just lie down, and why I have just picked up these particular exercises is because mostly after your C-section or even your normal birth, vaginal birth, you are kind of in this position where you're lying down all the time. So these are some exercises that you can literally do on the bed itself, which is why I picked up these particular ones, because these are the ones that I kept doing for a very long time while I was just restricted to the bed. So the first exercise that we are doing is just the rotation of the feet, and side by side you can also rotate your arms, but I'm just going to lie down and show you what we're going to do. I'm going to be doing less repetitions and you can do obviously more. So we're just going to start out lying down straight and rotating one foot clockwise for about I'm going to do 4 to 5. Obviously we have less time here, but you can obviously do 10 to 12. So you rotate one foot at a time clockwise and then anti-clockwise. So that's how you just kind of rotate. This is a very, very simple thing. one, like that. You can feel the stretch here and on your leg. And then you bring it back up here. And then you slide the other. You could do them alternate or one leg at a time. Two. Three. I'm going to be again doing 4 to 5. But then you could do 10 or 15 of them. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. So this is again a very, very simple exercise that you can do. It's going to help strengthen the core. And now the next exercise that I'm going to do is again very, very favorite of mine, which I am still doing because it's an exercise which is very, very good to build your glutes. But currently I'm going to show you this exercise to strengthen your pelvic floor muscles, which become very, very weak. I'm sure most women now definitely do Kegels. You can obviously start off with your Kegels exercise right a few days after your postpartum. But this is my favorite exercise that I still do. Now, of course, I use weights, but postpartum right away, you can just start without any weights at all. Again, now you put your hands right to the side of your body. Press them firmly on the ground. You also place your feet like this and press them against the ground firmly. Now we are going to breathe in and pull ourselves up like this. These are called the glute bridges. They're also called just bridges. So you just pull them up like this. While you do this, you're going to pull your pelvic floor muscles inwards, you know. And then you're going to go down. Please make sure you're doing this very, very, very gently. There is no jerk while you do this. Now I'm going to do 10 to 12 of these. I also suggest you do 10 or 12 of these. 10 would be good to start. So you just pull yourself up again here. When you come up here, your feet have to be flat on the floor, pressing firmly against the floor, and your glutes have to be squeezed in, and from the internal side you pull your pelvic floor muscles inwards, and then you release, go down. So this is some exercise that you can literally keep working and building on. Once you have your baby a little grown up, you can just have your child sit on your lap here, and you could do that using the weights. Three, four. If you find it very difficult to hold up in the glute, in the bridge position, you could just go up and then just pause a little and come down. But if you are comfortable, I suggest you go up, squeeze your bottoms, pull the pelvic floor muscles inside, and pause. And then gently come down. This is a really, really very good exercise to work the. This works your core. This works your pelvic floor muscles. Also works your glutes. So you just do about 10 to 12 of these, and 3 sets. All right. So this is one of my favorite exercises, like I just told you. Now we're going to be doing another exercise, which is the toe taps. So you come up in a position like this, and we're just gonna tap the toe down one by one, just like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, I'm just doing 10 for you, but obviously you can do more of these. And this is some exercise that you can easily do, about 10 to 12 reps of these. The next exercise that I'm going to show you is something that you only perform if you've had a normal delivery, but if you had a C-section, you really want to avoid this one. This is a very basic calf and cow stretch that is done in yoga also. Now we are focusing on building and strengthening your core. So you come up here in the tabletop position and you pull in like this. You come in the dog position. While you do this, you again pull your pelvic floor muscles inwards. And then you go in the cat position. Very, very good stretches, but this is something you only do if you've not had a C-section. If you've had a C-section, you really want to wait for a while before you start on this one. I'm again doing just 5 to 6 of these. So these are some of the very, very basic exercises that you can do at your place, wherever you are. You really don't want to be, you don't really need a mat or something. These can easily be performed on the bed itself. I'm just going to put the phone up. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly take your questions in case there are any, and then we will continue. Okay, so Priya had a question. Can home exercises be as good and effective as working out in the gym? Okay. How often is it recommended to exercise after delivery? Strength training, I'm just going to answer. Okay, so somebody also asked me, what are the ways that you can begin exercises, when you can start exercise? I'm just going to answer all of them right now. Okay. So I was asked, how do you start? How can you start your fitness journey? Okay, so the first question that was asked was, are home exercises effective as much as going to gym? Number one, yes, it is, definitely, because the idea is that you exercise and you can pretty much exercise with all the basic equipments at home. Even with just dumbbells, you can do so much at home with just your body weight, simple dumbbells, resistance bands, and it can be as effective as going to the gym. But number two, again, it kind of depends on what kind of goal do you have. If you have a goal that you want to, kind of build this really good physique, then obviously you have to go to the gym. But if you just want to stay fit, you want to have just good lean muscle and you want to maintain your health, then you can definitely work out at home. And if it makes you feel any better, when I started working out at home, I had lost almost 17 kgs at home itself, and I had literally just dumbbells and very, very basic equipment at home. With just walking 1 hour every day and doing some very basic home workouts, I lost 16, 17 kgs at home itself. And that's when I actually went to the gym, because then, of course, my goals changed. So they are very, very effective. But the thing is that you just got to be consistent. What happens with staying at home and working out at home is that you kind of feel that, you know, you're home, aaj nahi to kal kar lenge, you know, like that. So consistency is very important, whether you can maintain it at home or you want a gym for yourself that, you know, I have to go out and work out, that's your take. But home workouts are equally effective in maintaining good health. What happens if you work out too soon after postpartum? Nothing will happen if you work out too soon. But that too soon has to be number one, has to be given permission. Your doctor has to give you permission that you're perfectly fit to start or resume your exercise postpartum. If you were doing something before, you will be able to start off at, you know, something closer to that very soon. But if you've never worked out before, you can start, but you really need a go ahead from your doctor. The only time that you should completely stop is if you're feeling any discomfort, pain, like I've discussed in the previous episode also, and I will come to that again. You have to stop then, otherwise nothing will happen. The more mobile you are, the more active you are, it's going to be good for your health. So it's a good thing if you can start off soon. So how do you start your journey postpartum? I have talked about it a lot in the first episode. See what what body part fat you will lose last or first, that purely depends on your genetics. Some people will start losing fat from their face, some will start losing it from their abdomen. It depends on how, number one, how your body stores fat, the areas your body stores excess fat, and how it's going to lose it from. It's not something that anybody can guarantee you that this part of your body will start losing fat first, or for that matter, even if you're working for any certain body part to lose fat, that's not how it happens. Alright, so does workout postpartum hurt? So if you're somebody who's starting workout for the first time, there is something called muscle soreness. Of course, if you're going to work out, your muscles are going to be sore, and it may be painful for somebody who's never experienced it before. But if you're somebody who knows what muscle soreness is, you can easily and very quickly differentiate between muscle soreness and any discomfort or pain which is not related to muscle soreness. So that's something that I suggest you are consciously aware of. Obviously, if you're going to work your muscle, it's going to be a little painful and it's going to be sore the next day. But if you're having any kind of pain in your C-section scar or your pelvic heaviness, or you experience unusual pain in your back, or you have any kind of bleeding or any kind of spotting, I would highly, highly recommend that you stop, because that is not normal and you need to speak to your doctor. How to build stamina. Obviously, that's something that I speak about all the time, that it's very, very important that postpartum you start to work out, because you need to build your stamina and strength more than being size XYZ, you know, because that's something that you've literally lost in the 9 months of pregnancy, unless of course you're really fit. But even then, something that you really lose is your strength and stamina postpartum, and it becomes even worse if you have a C-section, or even after a normal delivery, you kind of lose a lot of strength and stamina, because so much energy goes into bringing a child into this world. So that's something that you really, really should and need to work on postpartum. And obviously, the most easiest and the simplest things I would suggest would be to start walking. That's the best you can do for yourself. Okay, so now what I wanted to also discuss with you is the exercises that you should completely avoid doing postpartum. The exercises that I showed you today are also safe if you've been diagnosed with a diastasis recti, if there is any kind of bulging on your stomach, if you're unaware of it, you have to seek help. You need to see your doctor and be sure that you are not experiencing one of that. So what I would suggest is postpartum, the last area that you really want to start working on right away is that core. You really want to heal it and not strain it or not make it, you know, you don't want to start doing abdominal crunches and leg raises and things like that to make things worse on your muscles of the stomach, because during this 9 months the muscle that has been really separated and, you know, stretched out to the core is your core muscles. So you really want to give it first of all that much time so that it goes back, your uterus goes back to normal, you know, normal position and size, and your muscles go back, and you know, you have to work on healing them and strengthening them. So one thing that I would definitely suggest that you avoid right postpartum is any kind of very intense core workout. You really want to give it that much time, and any kind of pulling, pushing and lifting which you haven't been doing before, any kind of exercise that you have never done prior to your pregnancy should not be performed right after. For example, if you're not somebody who's been running, so postpartum is definitely not a time that you want to start preparing for half a marathon, you know. So you get my point, that if you have not done anything before, this is not a good time to start doing something so intense. So you always have to start very, very basic, very, very simple, and make sure that you're not pushing yourself too hard. Be gentle to yourself. Again and again, I want to remind you, do not, as a mother, even otherwise, if you're anybody who's trying to lose weight, trying to stay healthy, trying to stay fit, you have started your fitness journey, please be kind to yourself. And please try to change yourself for the love of your body and not for the hate of your body. So the more you love your body and you want to change, you are more, you're going to be more gentle and more considerate towards your body. So these are the core workouts, like I told you, should be definitely avoided. Lifting something off the floor after C-section is definitely suggested that you start lifting anything off the floor 6 months later. But then again, it depends on how you feel and how your exercise routine pre-pregnancy was and how you were, how active you were during your pregnancy. So anything that you were able to do during your pregnancy, you should be able to go back to that 3 to 4 weeks postpartum, again after taking your doctor's permission. So that's how it's supposed to be. Lifting off the floor should definitely be avoided, and starting anything new that you've never done before should be avoided again. Now, when is it okay to start doing high intensity interval training? That's a question that always comes to your mind. The reason being because HIIT workouts generally burn so much more calories, and because anybody who's trying to lose weight has the agenda of burning more calories, so obviously HIIT is a preferred, you know, form of exercise. HIIT or CrossFit, you know, anything which has a high intensity would be something that would come to your mind. But when is it okay to start doing these workouts postpartum? Again, depend on how active you were during your pregnancy or pre-pregnancy, but I would suggest any kind of high intensity interval training should be started only 3 to 4 weeks postpartum after taking your doctor's advice, and that too gradually. Please do not jump into an HIIT workout. It could be very, very stressful for your body and it could lead to very serious injuries and also bleeding. So you really want to avoid that unless your body is really ready for it and your doctor's given you a go ahead. Now, when is it okay to start strength training? This is something that I did, I have fallen in love with, and I still do. So because I was against strength training before my pregnancy, I took a long break during my pregnancy. I was able to go back to lifting and strength training much sooner, but I again took my 6 months time, and post that I started my strength training. So that's like I said, it again depends on how active you were before and how and what you were doing before your pregnancy. But when it comes to strength training, you can definitely start off with body weight exercises first and then go to strength training, and start with very basic and light weights and then work your way up. Just do not lift, because everybody wants to lift, and you know, so for that reason you can just start with something very basic. Yes, you can please leave your questions below and then I'll answer them. So you can just start with light weights and work your way up. That's how it's supposed to be done with strength training. So the next thing that I want to talk to you guys about is what if you have started exercising and it still feels painful after 6 weeks. Now, usually if you start exercising, you are generally given a go ahead from your doctor and that's when you start. But what if you continue to feel pain, right, with pain while you're exercising? Now, any kind of pain postpartum except for muscle soreness is not normal. If you feel pain in your back or your vagina or your C-section scar, you are to stop exercising and you are to check up with your doctor. These are not normal signs. So usually what happens, like I discussed in the previous episode also, that you kind of feel that, you know, you've just started exercising and any kind of pains and you know, discomforts are normal because you have started exercising. Exercise should not bring you any kind of pain or discomfort except for muscle soreness, obviously, because if you've never worked out before. So that's something that you really want to check up with your doctor first and stop immediately if you feel any discomfort or pain. Even after 6 weeks, it is not normal and you need to stop and take a little break and then start back again. Now there are some signs that your body will indicate and show you that whatever you are doing, whatever form of exercise you've chosen to do, is too much and you're pushing yourself too much. Like I've said again and again, any kind of bleeding and spotting, any kind of dizziness, feeling out of breath, any kind of pain, heaviness in your pelvic area is a sign that you're pushing your body too hard and that it's not ready for what you're doing. Which is why I also suggested that before you jump and before you start any kind of workouts, any kind of regime that you make for yourself, it's very important that you start with something very simple and basic, and you work your way up so that you know that your body is ready. If you feel any of these signs, please stop immediately and check up with your doctor and take a break. Now, on that note, I'm going to end this session and leave you with this little advice that small is all, doing less is more too. So these exercises that I did with you today, they look very simple, they're very easy. And you know, it may feel like isse kuch nahi hoga, but believe me, that's how you start. You don't just hit the gym one day and you start working out. That's not how you happen. That's not how it happens. You have to prepare your body and you have to get ready. You have to build. So that's about it in this session, and we are going to be talking about a lot of things and doing more exercises in the coming live sessions. I'm just going to see if there are more questions. All right. right, I think I've kind of answered most of them. Is doing cardio, only doing cardio good? Well, first of all, I have to say doing any kind of exercise is good as long as you're doing it consistently. When it comes to cardio, I feel just doing cardio is something, which kind of leads to a lot of loose gain, and you really want to build that muscle, and strength training is one of my favorite things to do. So I highly recommend strength training, especially for women. So that's my take on cardio, but we're going to be doing a lot of discussion on that particular aspect in the coming sessions. So for today, I'd like to say thank you so much for joining me on this live, and see you guys tomorrow next week, Tuesday, 7 p.m. again on Namami Live. Thank you for joining the live, and I think I answered everybody's questions, but you still have any questions, you can put them down in the comment box below, and I will get back to you. Thank you.